You are riding towards a corner, you are in the middle of the corner, and you lean your motorcycle, and you're leaning and leaning, and you lean more and more, and you are wondering, could you lean even more, or was this almost too much? Keep watching, cause I'm gonna tell you three really important factors that have a huge influence on how much you can actually lean your motorcycle. Also keep watching if you already can lie with your motorcycle on the street and just want to know how far away you still are from hospital. It pretty much comes down to 3 points, some of which you can influence and some of which you can't. But I also have to say that in reality, there are 100 different points that can influence the lean angle of your motorcycle. But when it comes to driving behavior, somehow everything influences anything. So because I don't want to talk one whole day about this topic, I've broken it down to those 3 points. Also, those 3 points have subtopics and are somehow related to each other. But as always, if you want to know more about a specific thing, then just let me know in the comments. The first topic is something you can only slightly influence by choosing the right tires. The other two topics can quite easily be influenced by you, but let's get started with the first one. It is the friction coefficient. This term is often used quite general in many different areas of physics, but the definition is always the same. In our case, we're talking about the friction coefficient between the road and the tire of your motorcycle. The official definition, which is valid no matter if you're talking about the road and the tire or two completely other materials like ice cream and your tongue. The friction coefficient represents the ratio of the frictional force to the normal force between two bodies. For making this more understandable, let's draw a sketch. We can take a tire for our example. The blue one is the normal force, which is, for example, the weight of the tire in our example. The red force could be a force generated by lateral acceleration, for example when we're driving through a corner. The pink force, FF, is the frictional force holding against F. We also see the road in the sketch, and in our case, the friction coefficient is the friction coefficient between the tire and the road. The friction coefficient is the frictional force divided by the normal force. The limit of the frictional force is the point where the tire just doesn't have enough grip anymore and slips away, meaning that the friction coefficient is a factor to influence the maximum grip. Now we define the friction coefficient, but what does it have to do with the question from the beginning, how much can motorcycles lean? When you're riding through a corner, there's the force F trying to pull your bike out of the corner. By leaning, you're trying to hold against this. But you can also lean as far as your friction coefficient allows this. Because for a stable driving situation, the frictional force and the force F always have the same amount. The more you lean your motorcycle, the higher the force F gets. Therefore, the frictional force also needs to be higher. But let's get back to the formula. The frictional force can only get as high as the product of the normal force and the friction coefficient. When you lean even more so that the force F gets higher, then this means that you've crossed the limit and your motorcycle will start to slip away. Now you know how the friction coefficient is defined and what it means for your motorcycle. But how can the friction coefficient be changed and can you influence it? Partly, because the friction coefficient is mainly defined by the material and the texture of the surfaces. This means the tire and the road. While you can definitely choose the tires, but you can't say that a specific tire has a higher friction coefficient on a specific road than another. Usually, sport tires will lead to a higher friction coefficient than touring tires, for example. But it still depends on so many other factors, for example, temperature, applied force, surface pressure, velocity, lubrication, whether or not you subscribe to my channel. No, okay, that was a joke, but I still wish you all the grip in the world if you do. Sport tires, for example, need higher temperatures for getting to the highest possible friction coefficient compared to touring tires. But so much about the friction coefficient. I know it's a complex topic and not everything can be covered in 3 minutes, but if you want to know more about it, just let me know in the comments. Let's go on with point number two, tire width. The width of your tire doesn't per se change the grip. It does indeed change how far you can lean your motorcycle, or better said, how much you have to lean your motorcycle. Here's why. in physical equations, it doesn't matter how far a motorcycle is leaning for creating a stable cornering situation. What does matter is the lean angle of the resultant. The resultant is the line that connects the center of gravity of the motorcycle with the point where the tire meets the road. The broader the tire, the more the contact point between the tire and the road needs to travel away from the middle when the motorcycle begins to lean. Therefore, you have to lean the motorcycle even more. If you want to know more about this point, check out this video that I've made about this topic specifically. But remember, the broader the tires are, the more the motorcycle can and has to lean for exactly the same driving situation. And we go straight on to point number three, which is your posture. This is quite similar to the situation with your tire width. If you want to change your lean angle, you can definitely do most by changing your seating position or your posture out of these three points. Even though it's kind of a fake change, but well, you still can't change the physics. Okay, I'll make it easy for you. Every motorcycle tire combination has a maximum lean angle. But for physical equations, what counts isn't the lean angle of the motorcycle, since there's usually a rider on top of the bike. What counts is the motorcycle and the rider as a unit. So it's either possible to stay quite upright and push the motorcycle down, or to lean or hang really low beneath your motorcycle and keep the motorcycle really upright. What matters is the angle created by the contact point of the tire and the road, and the center of gravity of the combination of the motorcycle and the rider. I'd love to hear some feedback from you, this time especially about the level of technical and physical deep dive here. See you next time!